What is going on, fish heads? Jen Crevasse, Jekyll Bates, and I have got some fun patterns to show you guys this morning. I'm going to try and keep you as updated as I can as I transition through this journey across country over to Georgia from Arkansas. It is 2 days before Thanksgiving. Target move date is December 8th-ish. Hopefully it'll come a couple of days sooner, but I'm not sure we can get everything packed up before then, although I'm going to be packing furiously. All of the extras, everything that's not needed is to essentially be a part of this studio and keep that. The studio is actually the last thing that I'm going to be doing, breaking that down. But the process has started. Anyways, let's start with these little gems of goodness. This, I've gotten so many questions, you guys. This is a Yakima T60. It's actually a 963 is the model number. And I've gotten so many questions as to where I get blanks. And I hope that I'm not misunderstanding you guys, but these are actual brand name baits. These are the originals. Now, Yakima Bait Company has also purchased the Worden Rooster Tail. So a lot of it deals with the trout and salmon hunting type stuff. And these are them. These are very large. They're 6-inch. Flatfish have been around for a very long time. So these are not blanks. I'm not getting them like from overseas, or I'm not sure where they have them. I would believe probably Japan originally. But they're not that easy to find. You can find them in like the 2 inches and 3 inches. But these are for trolling. So not just the West Coast and the Upper East Coast, like the Salmon River, New York. Although you frequently see them more on the West Coast than anywhere else. But Canada, a lot of Great Lakes stuff, trolling, those guys use them as well for the large lake trout. You can see Mac right there with a great big monster lake trout. So that's the kind of fish that they're going after. That's the target species for this particular order. I still have a bunch more coming. I gotta just relay a quick little story about Bass Pro, and unfortunately it's not a good story. So ordered 6-inch bass flat baits from Bass Pro, and they sent me 4-inch, and don't know why. So I did a refund and then talked to the lady over the phone, and she said everything was fine. Ordered the 6-inch ones, ordered a bunch of them. They sent half of them. So this is the second time. And then they didn't refund my account. So I know that there was a difference in price between a few of them, but I was very specific in the quantity that I told her that I wanted. I was very specific in the difference in price that was done over the phone, and then they sent me half my order. So then I had to scramble. I'm getting the refund from Bass Pro because they were able to go back on the recording and see that, yeah, that's exactly what happened. So yeah, they just absolutely didn't deliver, and that sucks. That's a shame, because I normally have fairly decent luck when I order online, but they're not easy to find. This is the lake trout pattern, I'm trying to think of, let me see if I can pull it up real quick, where I ended up getting the rest of them, which was easy peasy lemon squeezy. I probably should have gone with the smaller company to begin with. I want to say it was it Fisherman's Marine? On the West Coast, so yeah, I think Fisherman's Marine is where I ended up getting these from. And again, these are the T60s, and the full number, if you guys are interested in these great big 6-inch flatfish, is 963-MSFC. So this is my own lake trout pattern. And these are just Amazon stencils. These are not anybody's stencils per se. And it's been a long, like years since I ordered them. So please don't ask me to figure out where I exact, but I know it was a stencil that I got off Amazon. It was a large sheet stencil that I had to cut up into like 4 pieces to make it applicable for these things. So it was like a 12 by 12 inch, 1 foot long card. And then we did Hamilton Craws, modified for, and he just wanted these for the colors. Usually when you're trolling, it's really bright loud colors, awesome patterns, but I modified the Hamilton Craw just for these. Folded that stencil over. These are hand cut stencils for my craw. And put those white dots, made some eyeballs. And you guys saw the fire calico. This is a chromed one, and it's really hard to show clients how gorgeous this one is and how much chrome still shows through. But this is on a chromed bait. You can see the reflection right around here. If you're looking at that particular point, this is mirror chrome that's been meshed over. And this is that, that circus clown type deal. Just a really pretty, I love chrome patterns, and you can see the reflection better on the bottom of this. Like if you're looking down here, so it's just, you don't have to prep anything. You don't have to clear coat it the first time. These have got three layers of clear coat on them because they're going to be trawling. And then we're just waiting on the rest of his baits to show up so I can repaint those. So those are the patterns thus far. There's going to be a couple of sexy shad type deals in the next batch that he's gotten. I've got a peacock baby shad, baby bull shad. You guys have also asked where I can get blanks of this. It's not, they don't make blanks of this. I mean, the company does. Ketchco and Mike Buca do. But these are not knockoffs. I don't paint knockoffs. I won't paint knockoffs. I am affiliated with Mike Buca at this point in the game, so that would be a slap in the face, and I hope they never make them. But you can get them at Carl's, shopcarls.com. Right now, they are on sale. They're normally $15, folks. They're under $9 for the originals, not my customs. Customs in my patterns, you can only pick up on my website. My website at www.checklebaits.com is still selling the mess out of these. So it's the only bait that I left on the website. I'm going to be modifying that website to mostly do swim baits in the future. But I will still have a select number of patterns, and you can always special order from me. I have kind of dwindled that down because of the move, that whole thing. So just keep in mind that things are, everybody's orders that are open with me right now are going to be completed before I accept any new website orders. So this, Matt ordered this deep, and it's, I love these bullshad deeps, but he ordered it in the old Strike King. You remember the orange belly craw, or it's not the orange belly, but the actual orange craw. I think they still sell the orange belly, which is just a hint of orange. But this, it really reminds me of the Cleveland Browns too. You know, you guys make that association however you want. But this is a very cool concept bait, and it was a special request for a customer. I guess he absolutely destroys and crushes on that color, so he wanted to modify that into the Strike King orange craw. So I did it for him. If you guys have like really off the wall special requests for stuff, I'll do it as long. Now, if I think that it looks absolutely terrible, I will tell you that I don't think that that might be the best pattern for a swim bait. But if it's a loud color like this, this is not quite fluorescent, but almost. This is that sunset red that I mixed down with a little bit of fluorescent red, just to pull the orange out as much as I could on this bait. But fun. I had a blast doing this one for you, Matt. So this one headed out the door as well. It's got its, I did three. I'm doing three on swim baits just because they're going to get destroyed by big fish. You guys are eyeing these up, and I can't wait to show you. Now, before we get too much into the dirty shads that have been transformed, I wanted to show you guys the differences between... This is Mike Buca's original 4-inch that Ketchco adapted into this bait. Okay, you can see that there's a little bit difference of a profile. This one's 3.75, this one is the full 4. So you can see that this dwarfs it a little bit. And I like giving you guys comparisons when I can, simply because it's sometimes it's hard if you're like, well, where did this bait come from? How was the concept design? This is what it was designed from, is Mike's original 4-inch. He still sells them, I believe. I think. I don't want, don't misquote me. I'm not 100% on this. But this is part of a four-piece order. This is actually the other ones. This is the same order. But Bill Santana asked for these two and then the two dirties up top that you're about to see. One's in the mahi-mahi pattern, which is a really interesting concept for that particular type of shad. So it was that, again, that was fun out of the box thinking. And then the original peacock that I love doing. And this is not mesh. This is just a plain body style. It's got some gold up top. And in the sunlight, that really shines. And then obviously you can see when you match up the build, this profile is very similar. This is beefier. The original resin pour is beefier. But these are just dynamic baits. And for an ABS plastic, first of all, they used incredibly good plastic on these. So a lot of the swim bait snobs, and I say that with the utmost affection for you guys and gals, because I'm becoming one. So let me just, okay, I have to go down this rabbit hole. When I started getting into painting swim baits, I wasn't fishing swim baits. And to me, this is barely even a swim bait because it's so gosh darn small. But I started painting, you know, everybody starts painting out. You get a few of these here and there, and then you start getting into the more boutique-y type stuff. And before you know it, you realize that as many times as I've said in my life that if fishing were drugs, I'd be dead, because fishing in itself is, it's an addiction. And the gear and the tackle and hundreds of thousands of dollars, and now I'm an airbrush artist, and it's just like, it snowballs, and you guys know that, right? So, then when you get into swim baits, you realize that of the drugs, let's say your average crankbait, lipless, rattle traps, that's probably like the marijuana. But then you get into swim baits, and that's like the heroin. It really, when you start, I mean, that's a lot. That's a lot of money. But then you see the kind of fish that are caught on swim baits. And it's really hard to fish anything else once you start fishing these things. These are great introductory baits in the swim bait part, the species of swim bait, to get kids into. Everybody can fish these 3.75 and 4-inch swim baits. They're easy to throw. You don't need a whole different type of setup to throw them. Medium heavy rod is my recommendation, although I'm sure I'll get lots of comments on what you guys have for the smaller swim baits. These are not big swim baits. When I hear people on YouTube and TV saying, oh, I'm throwing this big swim bait and it's one of these, come on, man. Come on, no. Start getting into the crack cocaine that we all get into with this. And I say that affectionately. You guys know what I'm talking about, especially the swim bait junkies out there that are just specifically only throwing swim baits. You know who you are. This is the Alewife. So the Alewife is his pattern that he requested along with that P. And then we got, that was just my little rabbit hole of designer drugs of the fishing industry. That's pretty much what, you guys know I'm right too. You know I am. Love doing this mahi for him. And it was a different kind. He's like, what if I threw you a curveball and you put a mahi pattern on a dirty shad? And I'm like, hey, if it's going to catch you fish, I'll put whatever you want on there, bud. So it turned out really cool. I'm really excited to have him get these. And he's been extremely patient, so I'm kicking him some goodies as an extra. But, and this is all free-handed. I'm no longer using stencils for shading. I've dialed that, this Awada Eclipse, I have dialed down so good that I'm rarely using any kind of stencil for shading the gill plates anymore. And this is a phenomenal bait. These dirties are absolutely awesome in their gill plating. That a lot of time went into making these. Just super pumped to have put a couple of these patterns together for Bill. So coming at you, Bill, thanks for your order. I know I'm not waiting until the very last, but you guys were really digging on this perch too. I did foil it, so there is some foil in there, which is why it looks so natural. And that's all a freehand stencil on the gill plates as well. A lot of hand detailing This is all hand detailed on the fins, as is the tail. That's all hand detailed and painted. And then same with that pec fin. So I know you guys were just like jonesing to see these. And this is it close up. It's no trick photography. It really looks like a perch. This is probably one of the best perch I've put together to date. And it really was easy on this bait to do that. And no offense, Mike. I love bull shad. I live and breathe bull shad these days pretty much. But smoothie baits, my friend, and the profile on these, just, this is a really well put together bait. Super happy with it. Just really nice. I could just sit here and say, you guys probably could too. Just sit here and stare at this bait all day. If it ended up in a frying pan, I mean, accidentally, but you know what I'm saying. And then last but not least, I got a customer request from Skip to do a blue with black, just a thin strip of black. He wanted it very simple, very stripped down, the gold, but he wanted it bloody. I normally am not into bloody baits. I normally, if I'm doing a hatch match, like a blueback herring or a shad, I try and make it look like this, but he wanted it bloody. So we gave him bloody. We have the realistic shad dot, which was done with the airbrush. These are jets and eyes, those mirror chrome silvers. Wow, so pretty. John over at Jetson pulls it off again. I did the veining because he wanted it bloody. I normally would do like a silver or a gray under here if I mesh it. And I'm not like this one up here, that's not meshed at all. There's a lot of stuff that I don't mesh. Some of the stuff that I do, obviously for obvious reasons, looks really cool. This, because he wanted bloody, I decided to do the dying look. And I can't, I don't want to pull off what somebody else does. TK does one where when you get it wet, you throw water on it, that paint shifting color goes from white to pink, and that blows my mind every single time that I see it. But I don't imitate and wouldn't imitate somebody else because I think originality and adaptation is where it's all at. I hope that makes sense to you guys. I even, not really cringe, but when somebody asked me to do a Strike King pattern, like, ah, really don't want to do that. So obviously I modified it a little bit so that it's not exactly like Strike King. And I do the same with my own patterns. And that's what you guys should be striving to do. Don't be me. Be the best version of yourself. Don't be me. Be the best version of yourself that you can possibly be. That's all I ask. And I've got to admit, I saw, I don't know, I forget whose it was, but I saw a dragon the other day. And I'm like, ah, I know where they got that idea. But it was cool. They did a really good job on a golden dragon. And I think he did a video on it too. So there's some cool stuff out there. Just make sure that if you are exactly copying somebody else's pattern or you're copying somebody else's concept that you know you didn't come up with your own on your own, just give the folks credit. That's all we ask. Those of you that are just starting out and you get really excited when you can pull off the patterns that you see me make on my videos, when I'm doing spray sessions or somebody else, just be humble enough to let us know that you got it from us and maybe thank whoever's pattern, you know, it's like, hey, and most of you guys do, but I see a couple that, so just be kind, be humble, take care of one another. We're community, we're not competition. That's my thing. And that said, that's pretty much all the news that's fit to print for today. Thanks for hanging out with me for 19 minutes and some odd change. Have a very happy Thanksgiving, folks. I will see you on the other side of Thanksgiving, and I'm going to try and put together that ink video that I keep promising is going to come out. It's still in the works. Again, the shop is going to be the very last thing that I take down, but I am in the midst of flurry for trade shows with Mike. So there's a lot of stuff, and you guys are not going to see any of those patterns, none of them, until Mike reveals them. So we're keeping all that a secret. Love ya, mean it, have a great day, cheers, and happy casting. From Jekyll Bates.